Welcome to this video, in which I will explain the painful knee replacement. I will explain the causes of why a knee replacement can continue to be painful, how you can find out what the reason is in your specific case, and how it can be treated. But first, I have to explain you what a total knee replacement is. It is actually not a full replacement of the knee, but rather a replacement of the gliding layers of the knee. The gliding layer on the femoral side is replaced by a prosthetic cap. On the tibial side, the gliding layer is replaced by a base plate, which is fixed onto the bone with a stem and a keel. Onto the base plate comes a polyethylene insert, which articulates with the femoral component. And during the procedure, the exact three-dimensional geometry of the knee in relationship to the hip and the ankle is restored. This is how a total knee replacement looks on frontal radiographs, and this on lateral radiographs. On the lateral radiographs, you can also see the patella, of which the gliding layer can be replaced with a polyethylene layer, depending on the surgeon's preference. And actually, total knee replacement usually works very well. 85% of the patients are very satisfied, but about 15% remain symptomatic. It is important to realize that pain in the beginning after the operation is normal. We know that the pain scores improve until 18 months after the procedure. But if the pain persists thereafter, there are some potential causes that you need to check. Here you see the list of the 8 most common causes. I will go over them. The first and most important thing you really have to rule out if you continue to have pain is an infection of your prosthesis. Usually, such an infection is relatively mild in the sense that there are no general symptoms like fever or sickness. That's why we call it a low-grade infection. That means that the symptoms are confined to the knee itself. The knee is constantly painful, swollen and warm. To rule out infection, a blood sample with determination of the sedimentation rate and CRP is needed. In case these are elevated, you need an aspiration of the joint fluid. When bacteria are found in the fluid, your knee prosthesis is infected, and that is bad news. It is bad news because most often it means that the prosthesis needs to be removed, then a period of antibiotics, and when the knee infection is cured, a new prosthesis can be implanted. We call that a two-stage revision. Just giving antibiotics and leaving the infected prosthesis inside will almost never cure the infection, for the simple reason that the antibiotics cannot reach the prosthesis surface where the bacteria are sitting. That is why a two-stage revision is usually necessary when the prosthesis is infected. The second possible reason for persistent pain is overhang or oversizing. That means that the prosthesis is hanging over the edge of the bone and rubs against the capsule, which causes pain. In a normal situation, the prosthesis lines up with the edges of the bone, like you see here. Overhang causes pain on the area of the overhang, or more diffuse pain when the overhang is on both sides, like in oversizing, when the prosthesis is too large and hangs over on both sides. In such cases, there usually is also a feeling of tightness and constriction around the knee, like as if there is a constantly tightening belt around it. A local injection sometimes helps to relieve the pain, but when overhang or oversizing is severe, the knee may have to be reoperated with repositioning or downsizing of the component. Third possible reason for pain: internal scar formation or arthrofibrosis. Excessive internal scar formation happens especially in people who develop aggressive scar tissue. We call them fibrotic healers. Sometimes the scar formation is so aggressive that they also develop calcifications into the scar, so that these become visible on X-ray. These patients complain of diffuse pain, tightness and stiffness with reduced flexion and extension. And again, that belt-like constrictive feeling around the knee. Usually, this situation improves over time, with the scar tissue finally loosening up, but sometimes that can take several years. Gentle mobilizations and sometimes a corticosteroid injection into the knee can facilitate this process. Fourth reason is persistent synovitis, which means that the knee remains persistently swollen and inflamed. This can be caused by either instability of the prosthesis or by metal allergy or hypersensitivity. In case of instability, the knee feels very wobbly and demonstrates excessive mediolateral laxity, which is caused by insufficient tension in the ligaments and the muscles. The treatment therefore consists of strengthening exercises and a temporary use of a stabilizing brace is sometimes also helpful. But in severe cases, the only solution sometimes is to reoperate and implant a so-called ultra-stabilized prosthesis. The second reason for persistent synovitis is metal allergy or metal hypersensitivity. This happens in patients who react to nickel, cobalt or chrome in the prosthesis. Occasionally, there is also a skin rash, like in this case, but that is rather exceptional, and usually there are no skin symptoms at all. So the diagnosis is not always so easy. Also, because most of the tests that we have are very unreliable. Some surgeons will advise a skin patch test or a lymphocyte transformation test to find out whether you are sensitive or allergic to metals, but the results are not always trustworthy. Standard anti-allergy medication is usually not that helpful in these cases, but oral corticosteroids can give some pain relief. In severe cases, the prosthesis may need to be exchanged to an anti-allergy implant out of oxinium and titanium, which contains no nickel, cobalt or chrome, and which solves the problem. Component micromotion or loosening can be another cause for pain. The reason is insufficient bonding of the implant to the underlying bone, which causes pain during weight bearing. On radiographs, you can witness that by a progressive radiolucent line between the component and the bone, and the technetium bone scan will demonstrate high signal intensity around the loose component. In mild cases, bone strengthening medication and bone strengthening exercises can be helpful, but in more severe cases, a reoperation is needed, with more solid fixation of the component with a thicker and longer stem. 6. Neuroma. Neuroma is a painful scar formation around the superficial nerve branch, usually on the medial side of the knee, where the infrapatellar branch of the saphenous nerve is located and which crosses the incision. It causes a pain zone with a trigger point that is extremely sensitive on local contact. Injection of the trigger point with a local anesthetic can confirm the diagnosis, and in case of pain relief, this can be followed by corticosteroid infiltration, by radiofrequency ablation, or by surgical excision of the neuroma. Malalignment is another reason for persistent pain or discomfort. In knee replacement, the correct three-dimensional anatomy of the knee in reference to the hip and the ankle are restored. But when this is not achieved ideally, the patient may experience an awkward feeling and the perception that the knee is just not feeling right. In such cases, a full radiological analysis with CT scan and a full leg standing X-ray is needed to clarify the problem. When the malalignment is minor, the patient may get used to the situation over time and no treatment is needed. But in more severe cases, a reoperation may be needed in order to restore the optimal three-dimensional configuration. Finally, problems with the patella can also be a cause of pain. Patellar problems can be related to the tendon, to the bone, or to the patellar tracking, and they can cause pain, tightness, or instability around the kneecap. Usually, there is also difficulty in using the quadriceps, like when going downstairs or getting up from a chair. When the patellar problem is minor, strengthening exercises of the quadriceps are usually sufficient to improve the situation. But in the more severe cases, a reoperation may be required to fix the problem. So, that's it. That is all you have to know about the painful total knee replacement, when you have it, and what you can do about it. Thank you for your attention.